Hi, it's Vernay from Vernay and Ryan's MJJ5 Fanatics channel here on YouTube. Today is games and puzzles. So I got my Moonwalker shirt on. If you can see behind me, you will see that the Neverland flag has been installed on its flagpole. So it's in its permanent spot behind me. Shout out to Rocky Joe. If you haven't seen the Piece of Neverland video where I explain how I got this flag and who I got it from and how she got it, please go back and check that out. Coming up this Monday, we have Ryan's makeup day. Ryan didn't feel well last Monday. So this Monday, he's gonna do his J5 Nights with Ryan video. And next week, I have a fun video. You get to meet my BFFFFFF because we also met through Michael Jackson, just like how I met my husband. And she and I traveled to Michael's funeral service together, and it's a whole drama behind that. So make sure you check out those videos next week. Today though, all about Michael games and puzzles. I'm gonna do the puzzles first, then I'm gonna do some games, then I'm gonna do my Vernay original, because yes, I made my own Michael Jackson game. Nobody ever plays it, I never bring it out. But you still get to see it. And then at the end of the video, I'm gonna show you our Moonwalker Arcade version, which I had my husband play, and I recorded different boards so you can get an idea of how the game goes, and I'll let that play out for the rest of the end of the video, okay? So let's get started with Michael Jackson puzzles. Okay, so I'm gonna start with a different type of puzzle. A Rubik's Cube, they used to be called. This is actually not a Rubik's Cube. This is a Michael Cube, but same idea. So, try to get you out the glare. The idea, obviously, is just like a Rubik's Cube. Instead of getting all the same colors, you want to create the album cover to make that. So I call it a Michael Cube. These are a little bit smaller than the regular Rubik's Cube sizes, but they are so freaking cute. I got two of them. I had ordered one, and then my husband has surprised me and ordered one for my birthday, and they actually end up coming like the same week. But these are awesome. These are cute little things. I love the Michael cubes. Now this puzzle is not really a Michael puzzle per se. I found this at Hobby Lobby, and if you look right here, it's an 80s puzzle, but Michael is right there where my finger is moving. See that? So I brought this whole entire puzzle called the 1980s, just so I can have that little blurb of Michael, which I'm very happy about. This I love because, you know, Bad is my favorite era. So this is a Bad jigsaw puzzle. And I did not have this during the Bad era. I actually just brought this at the end of last year. I didn't even know it exists. I saw it on someone else's page. And I was like, oh my God, I gotta find it. And then I found it. So, you know, I love that one. This next one is from the early 80s. It's called a puzzle form. So it's really big, as you can judge by the size of my head. So with the puzzle forms, after you put this part together, then these pieces down here, they're actually on a separate piece of paper, but this is wrapped up. But you put the big piece, the puzzle together, and then these are the interchangeable outfits that kind of stuck to it. And you can just peel them back off. So there you go with that. And that is called Puzzle Forms. And the company is called Color Forms. And you'll see a couple other Color Forms items in a few minutes. Of course, we have the traditional jigsaw puzzles. Now this particular one is not open, but I do remember my sister putting another one together for me, one of the ones over there on the shelf. But this one is still wrapped. But yeah, this is him with his llama and his little monkey bubbles. So these were really popular. It's also from the same company, the Color Forms, the same company as the other one. This is another Color Forms puzzle. This is the Thriller version of the Color Forms puzzle. And these puzzles are humongous. They have 500 pieces. And okay, I'm sorry, I felt like I was missing one. Anyway, this is Celebrity Superstars. I'm not really thrilled about, you know, the face. But you know, if I see Michael, I kind of have to grab it. I can't help it. But that's the celebrity superstar puzzles. Very weird. This one I thought was beautiful. It's Michael's face and it's the train station. I had just never seen it before, so, you know, I just think it's definitely worth sharing. It's a beautiful puzzle. This one's never been opened. Let me see if it has the number of pieces. It does not. It says Michael Jackson, a great Black American. And then it gives you like a history of Michael just right here in this corner. It's called Celebrity Series. And I don't know, it doesn't say how many. It just says it contains small pieces. But anyway, get out. I love that. I think that's a gorgeous puzzle. Okay. And then of course you have the Bravada puzzles. So this is the Thriller 25 version. These are all still wrapped, so that's why I can hold them like this. Don't worry, the pieces are not gonna fall out. They're not open. So this is the dangerous version. I think I would love to actually put that together and frame it, because dangerous cover is just stunning. And then this is the version from the Michael album. And let me see. Yeah, a lot of these don't say how many pieces. They just tell you the size of the puzzle. So, I don't know. But there's a million Michael puzzles out there, but that's the end of my puzzle collection. So now I'm going to tell you about some of the games. Of course, we have the J5 game. This is from 1972. You hear the pieces rattling around. I've never played this game. Actually, they're both open, but I've just never played them. So let's see what else. I have some Michael Jackson playing cards. Let's see if I can zoom in on you there. And I do have one pack that's open, so I can kind of show you a little bit from the open pack. The back is absolutely gorgeous. That's the back. And then these are the actual cards. Try to keep it out the glare. They're really, really, really nice. So let me show you them close up so you'll know what the packs look like. In case you wanted to try to find those. And one more time. Very nice pictures in here. So those are playing cards. Now, of course, if someone says, let's play cards, these are not my go-to cards, obviously. These stay in the Michael shelf. But, yeah. And then I have two more packs of Michael cards. They're also the same. Two of the same. I think one of these is open. Yeah, so I can show you inside this one as well. Hold on. Oh, you know what? I'm sorry, it's not open, but they're still wrapped, but you get a general idea. They're Michael cards. Okay. All right. Give me a second, because I don't like to... Ooh, I didn't know this one was in there, huh? I love this picture. That's one of my favorites of his photo shoots. Yeah. I don't mess with these things that often. I don't like anything to get messed up or anything to get wrinkled. Okay, so let's move on to the other color forms items that I was telling you had over here. So one was the dress up. And I'm going to tell you the honest truth. My cat's over there making crazy noises. This is not open. So I don't remember if this is one of those ones that you put in the oven, like the shrinky ding things. I think it's just like the color forms puzzle. I think it's little plastic outfits and you just kind of stick them on. But anyway, that is the dress up set, Michael Jackson dress up set. And then this is the deluxe edition of the same one. It's just much larger. And across the bottom, it says deluxe collector's edition. So these are essentially the same item, but you can see the significant difference in size. So let me move on now to some electronic games. Okay, so when I was young, the one thing I wanted, of course, was a Sega Genesis because Michael. So when Michael came out with Moonwalker, that's when I officially became interested in video games. I was so excited. Now, my case, I remember, was a little different. My case was black up here. I didn't have this white part up here. This is one that I ended up buying much later because mine's now is just a cartridge by itself. But this one is not open, and this one, I don't know if it was a reissue or what. Then of course we have the Wii game. This is the version for PlayStation. I don't have a PlayStation. And then this is a version for Wii. I actually don't have a Wii either. I don't know, the kids might, I don't know. I can't keep up. And then this is the collector's edition for the Wii that came with the I Love MJ t-shirt. So that's like the little box set for the Wii. And then they had the Xbox 360 collector's version that came with the t-shirt, the microphone, and the game. I'll show you that on the back. So right over here, you can see, I'm trying to move, this ring light is driving me crazy today. Right over here. So it came with the cordless mic, the game, and the t-shirt from Kinect. So we do have multiple Wii versions, but you get the point. So now I am going to show you, don't laugh, my homemade Vernay game. Okay, so you are looking at a Vernay original. This is my homemade Vernay game. So let me explain what's happening. I probably should have called it song match instead of album match, but anyway. So the idea is there's two separate boards that are exactly the same, board one, board two. They have Michael's solo albums across the top. Now this was before Escape came out, so obviously Escape hasn't been included. So the idea was to see who could put the songs under the right album and get their board filled the fastest between the two fans. So two fans would do this at the same time, competing against each other. So I'm gonna lay one down because I think it'll help me when I'm trying. I'm sorry, Nelly. I didn't know the cat was back there. So they would both get a baggie. I have them stored in this box right now, but they would both get a baggie of the same songs. And then the idea would be to match. So Liberian Girl, we would put under Bed. Behind the Mask, of course, would go under Michael. Where are we at here? Hollywood Tonight would go under Michael. Stranger in Moscow would go under History. So you get the point. So the idea would be, look at the cat. Disrespectful. So the idea would be to see which fan can get their board filled the fastest and empty their bag of songs. Now, when you have two fanatics, really you're just going for speed to see who can get it done the fastest. But when you have two people that don't know Michael's albums that well, that's when it's really funny, because they'll get their whole board done and then I'll be like, nope, you got six mistakes, but I wouldn't tell them which ones to switch. So they would have to go back and try to figure out which six songs or however many they had in the wrong place or the right place. And that's what made it fun. But it's not something that I pull out that often. I'm not sure why, but I worked very, very hard on this game. As you can see, look at all the pretty little cards I did. It's a whole box of them. You know, I put the Velcro on them. I'll show you. You know, I think I did a very good job on my Vernay homemade game. So tell me what you think in the comments about my game that probably should be called MJ Song Match instead of album. But yeah, I just wanted to share that with you because I'm very proud of my little game. It's humongous. But let's move on now to Moonwalker. If you've been to our home or seen some of our videos, you may know that we have several arcade games here in the MJ room. That is for several reasons. Number one, my husband loves video games. And number two, it's kind of our shout out to the Neverland Arcade. It's like our own little mini Neverland Arcade. But of course, we have to have Michael Jackson's Moonwalker. Now, the way we have this set up is that if we hit one switch, all these games come on. So I didn't want to have to deal with all of that noise while I was recording. So the games are turned off right now. But last night I did go and have Ryan play the game so that you will be able to see it. I recorded several screens for you all the way till he gets to the end. Now, you're not going to be watching him play continuously. You're just going to be watching clips. And we're going to start those right now. Okay, so Ryan will be playing the Moonwalker Arcade video game for us. We have a Switch, so when you turn one on, all the games come on. So it's a row of video games that you might hear in the background. Just focus on Michael. This is what we're gonna be doing. Stay tuned for Ryan. All right, Ryan's gonna get started. We're gonna be looking over his shoulder. Sorry for the other games in the background. I'll move up so you can hear Mikey. There's Ryan playing. I'm just gonna give you a couple seconds from this board and maybe another board. There's Bubbles. All right, Ryan's on a different board. When you record this from your phone, it looks like the screen is jumping, but it doesn't look like that in person. It's just how it's transferring over on screen. I mean, on camera, so I'm sorry about that. So the reason why it's blink and push start in the bottom corner is because you can pick multiple players. The other player would be in a red suit. And when you're playing just with Michael, well, I guess you can pick red or white. Uh-oh, Michael died. Uh-oh. There he is, he's back. We are still watching Mr. Ryan. I'm gonna give it just a few more minutes. Seconds, I should say. Gonna go save Annie over there. So Ryan has turned into the Moonwalker robot. That's like a bonus you get. Is that when you find Bubbles, right?
Mm-hmm.
And when you find Bubbles, you get to turn into the Moonwalker robot. On this round. I think this is one of the rounds that I like. Not on this version, but on the Sega Genesis version. The home version. Good job. Ryan is doing a fabulous job. What do you have to say for yourself, Ryan?
I'm rusty.
He said he's rusty.
Thank God for free play.
Yeah. Thank God for free play. Okay. at Ryan's hands. Look at those hands. Look at those hands.
Make the ghost dance.
Got the ghost dancing. I had my hand in the way. My bad. Okay. Evil Fortress.
Big's hideout now.
Oh, we're in Mr. Big's hideout, Ryan said. My baby working them hands.
It's a family show, right?
Yes, I'm not sure what you're about to say, so let's edit that. All right. Is no longer a threat to mankind. There's Michael's feet in the background. That's a lot to read. I was gonna read it to you, but I can't read that and hold the camera steady. So now you have seen some bits and pieces of the arcade version of Moonwalker. So I'm gonna let this play out and so you can see. Good job, buddy. Good job. All songs written and composed by Michael Jackson, available on CD, tapes, and records. Game concept and design by Michael Jackson. Sega. So much shorter than the home version. So much shorter than the home version. All right. Good job, Ryan. I don't know when I should stop. You gonna type your name in, honey? I'll stop here.